Hello, my name is Lina Shehadeh. I am from the Interdisciplinary Stem Cell Institute, Division of Cardiology, Department of Medicine, at the University of Miami Miller School of Medicine. Today, I am honored to show you a 5-minute video summarizing our recent publication at the Journal of Clinical Investigation, JCI Insight. The work revolves around a rare hereditary kidney disease called Alport Syndrome.
Alport syndrome is caused by mutations in the alpha chains of collagen 4. The type 4 collagen network is an essential component of basement membranes in kidneys, inner portion of the ear, and the eyes. Therefore, the main pathologies in an Alport patient are in these three organs. The basement membranes are extremely thin sheet-type structures whose function is to separate and support cells in many tissues. When the formation of type 4 collagen fibers is hampered due to gene mutations, such as the ones in Alport, the basement membranes of the kidneys cannot filter the waste products from blood and create urine in a normal fashion. Instead, blood and protein now pass through the urine. This causes Alport patients to rely on dialysis early in life and finally require kidney transplant. Because of defects in the cochlea, Alport patients suffer from bilateral sensory neural hearing loss. Also, because of deficits in the eye, Alport patients may suffer from visual abnormalities such as anterior lenticonus, where the lens protrudes to the outside of the eye. In our study, we used the Alport mouse, which has a mutation in collagen 4A3 gene similar to that in humans. We discovered that the bone protein called osteopontin is highly expressed in the renal tubules of the Alport kidneys. Since osteopontin is a secreted protein, as expected, it was highly elevated in the plasma of the Alport mice. This is interesting from a pharmacological standpoint because secreted proteins are accessible in the blood and therefore more druggable than other targets. Therefore, we decided to study the role of osteopontin in the Alport mouse. We crossed the Alport mouse with osteopontin deficient mouse and created Alport mice with heterozygous or homozygous osteopontin deletion. Since the Alport mouse does not receive any dialysis or transplant like an Alport patient, the mouse drops dead at the age of 10 to 12 weeks versus a normal 2-year lifespan of a mouse. We got excited when we found that the Alport mice lacking osteopontin lived longer. The Alport mice with reduced or no osteopontin showed improved kidney function and also reduced blood pressure. There was a tendency towards improved hearing function and a reduction in the pathology of the thickened basement membrane in the cochlear vasculature called stria vascularis. In the eyes of the Alport mice, there was significant lenticonus. However, this was ameliorated with osteopontin deficiency. As we observed in the cochlea, the capillary basement membrane in the retina are thickened in the Alport mouse, but this thickness is reduced with osteopontin deficiency. In summary, we observed improvement in the kidney, ear, and eye of the Alport mouse when osteopontin was knocked down. So how does this happen? Let's go back to the kidney and take a closer look. We see that in the kidney, the basement membrane is thickened in the Alport mouse. However, it's rescued in the Alport osteopontin deficient mouse. Similarly, the podocyte process count is normalized with osteopontin deficiency. In the Alport kidneys, there is a significant accumulation of cholesterol. However, this is much reduced when we do not have osteopontin in these Alport mice. So how does this happen? We found that in the Alport renal tubules, there is overexpression of a protein called dynamin-3. Dynamin-3 is co-expressed with LDL receptor. So therefore, the LDL receptor increases cholesterol influx that accumulates in the kidney. Showing mechanism in the paper, we identified that with elevated levels of osteopontin, there is elevation in dynamin-3 protein and then LDL receptor protein levels. This causes increased cholesterol influx and metabolic and mitochondrial dysfunction in the renal tubules of the Alport mice. We show this in the primary tubules from the Alport mouse, and we also show this in human kidney cell lines. With that, I'd like to thank the talented team members at the University of Miami from the Stem Cell Institute and various departments at the Miller School of Medicine.
So I thank you for watching our video. I hope you find our paper both interesting and useful. I sincerely hope that together we can build on this work and find a cure for Alport syndrome and other forms of kidney disease.